Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Briareos Kerensky, and welcome back for a first hour play on the Switch. I've just received Seiken Densetsu Collection, so let's take a look at this remake of the classic, Super NES and Game Boy titles. I don't really know how I'll structure this video, if during an hour I'll cover the games inside, or I'll dedicate 1 hour to each game, but that is rather unlikely, to be honest. So I guess that I'll start with the Game Boy title. So I'm trying to see where the options for the Game Boy emulation are, but right now I can't access a menu or anything. And unfortunately, yes, this is the Japanese version, as you have understood from the title of the game on the Switch dashboard, and unfortunately there is no English in this collection. So I see that there are no
Thank you.
So I'm trying to find... where are the emulation options, but can't seem to find them. I doubt it's home or the screenshot button. Oh, here they are. L and R together. Okay, the controls. Okay, quick save, quick load. Oh, I just reset the game, of course. Of course, again. So I've changed graphical modes, I don't really know I did that. Ah, okay, we just... ZR. I wonder if someone will ever do... I think I'll go with this style. For Game Boy emulation, will ever do a fading Game Boy screen emulation mode. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, it's that original Game Boys had an ink-based screen, and with age. The screen on the original Game Boy didn't display lines proper, rows, sorry, properly. It's nice you can change things on the fly. This is how I remember my Game Boy games, to be honest. So you can control your character with both the analog stick and the D-pad. I think the D-pad is the best, although it's not the D-pad on the standard Switch Joy-Cons is not the best. Thank you. Oh, it's Garland from Final Fantasy I. Yeah, maybe this is the most readable of all emulation styles. Okay, the menu is not ZR and ZL together, it's just ZL. Okay, this is totally scripted. So, if I'm not mistaken, this is also called Final Fantasy Gaiden in the West, probably. Maybe I'm completely mistaken about this. No horn breaking like in Zelda. Yeah, I'm getting a bit confused on the shortcuts. Because in Wii of X and Y you actually open the menus and L and R are for the emulation menus. Thank you. I don't know what to do with her. Oh, it even emulates flickering. Not that I'm really happy about that. Yeah, dead. I was probably... I will take a look at this, and this should be very well known by everyone. Okay, just two screen modes. Confirm the input with B. I forgot that. So, of course, this is the best known of these games in this collection. And probably should take more time with the other twos rather than this one. And yes, I did play it on the Super Nintendo, but I don't really remember it. I also like that the wallpapers change based on the screen mode you select. Didn't recall the scrolling was so bad. And with bad I mean that your character is not always centered in the screen. Thank you. I honestly didn't remember that the sprites flashed so much. Or maybe that was because I was playing the PAL version at 50 Hz and so certain things didn't go through the NTSC to PAL conversion. Maybe. So I'm also curious about... okay, 3 save states per game. Nice. Yeah, a bit of fumbling around with the controls because Honestly, I don't remember all the details of this game. Last time I played this was 20 years ago, something like that. Probably even more. So, yeah, the memory is a bit hazy. Yeah, the music in the Super NES games is just a tad less hard on the ears than on the GBA, on the Game Boy, not even the GBA. To get back when I first played this game, it was maybe when I was in junior high, so my knowledge of English at that time wasn't that good. Not that it's excellent right now, but now I'm playing in Japanese, another language that I don't really know. And yeah, a lot of parallels. I really wish that this collection would get a port for Western markets. But the biggest problem is the third game that, if I'm not mistaken, only received a a fun translation. And I don't know how Square Enix policies on fan translations are. I should stop blindly pressing B to advance a dialogue. Yeah, well, they will want to save again and on a different slot, but whatever. Okay, here I remember that I need a grappling hook. Do I have it? Okay. it's very slowly coming back to me. Very slowly. So I'll quick save here, and take a look at this one then, with the world famous Reese on the left, on the right, sorry. Oh yeah, now I noticed that there is a filter applied when things are full screen. A smoothing filter. But yeah, I've decided to have this collection then in an hour, because yeah, those are games you've already played or you can play in one way or another. And maybe, yeah, I'll do a review of this collection, but it will mostly I'll mostly cover the quality of the emulation and the features on the collection rather than the games themselves, because At the very least, the second and third chapters are most probably 20 to 30 hour games each, and I would really want to focus on ES8 at this moment, Plus I have Fire Emblem Echoes to play, so yeah. I totally won't be able to devote 40 or even 50 hours, including the Game Boy game, for to this collection. And I'm pretty sure I never played this one, although I did have a chance to buy a repo cartridge with the fan translation. Yeah, let's start with her. Because of course I will pick the girls. So right from the start, you have a party here rather than meeting characters along the way. Look at this mode 7. I don't want to say that the combat is more technical than the other two games, but it's a bit slower. Let's see if I'm able to die at the first enemy. Okay, it wasn't that far. This is completely scripted. Just to clarify. Oh, a man! You can't move people around. He was moving on his own. I think that for the Super NES emulation, this is the best screen ratio. Because I think that the smoothing filter applied to the full screen mode is a bit too much. I would have preferred the chance to choose between no smoothing or smoothing. Oh, you can move people around. The way made. So, okay, despite you can choose three characters from the start, you don't start with a party. Now I'm kinda interested to prolong this video a little bit and show at least one more character the starting sequel for at least one more character here to see if it's different at all. Yeah, controls are different from the other two games. it's I'd say a bit more technical here, especially with the pauses between each attack. So yeah, you know what? When I'm back in control, I will save and cut this video here, and I'll do a second video to show the start of each storyline here. Hopefully the storyline for the six characters is different, but I doubt it isn't. I will make a joke about this being the credits, but of course it's not. Finally arrived. So yeah, I've reached the first town, I'd say, and I'm cutting this video here. See you in part 2, where I'll explore all the openings for the other characters. So in the meantime, I hope you have enjoyed this video and you stick around for more. Briarios Kerensky, over and out.